Hello, and welcome to this video on how do we create a credential for Lansweeper in order to discover the most within your assets in your environment. There are two primary ways that Lansweeper can discover in your environment with credentials. We have credential-less and credentials. The credential-less is going to be pretty basic, and the credentials is a complete discovery. Let's first look at what credential-less looks like. We can discover credential-less through a process we called Credential-free Device Recognition. This process scans your asset and creates a fingerprint. That fingerprint can contain or comes from the MAC address, DHCP, ARP, ports that were scanned on that particular asset, lots more information. In fact, there's a lot more detail that is covered under Pro Tip number 39 if you want to dive deep into how we do CDR discovery. So while the credential-less provides you a lot of valuable information, a scan with credentials gives you a total and complete discovery of that asset. This information may include the software versions, the hardware, even down into the motherboard and the make and the model of your hardware, as well as the configurations of your operating system, the asset that you're scanning, and other details that only that asset has. So now that we understand the credential-less and scanning with credentials and the difference between these, let's jump into Lansweeper and create a credential. All right, once you've logged into Lansweeper, what we can do is come over here to the left side to your scanning button. And what we want to do is create a scan inside of your credentials. Let me explain real briefly the differences between the default credentials and my credentials. So the default credentials are going to be those credentials that are scanned that will cover all assets and are going to be the last resort scan. Lansweeper will first scan with your credentials first and then come back. If it cannot discover with those, it'll scan with the default credentials. In my environment, I'm going to create inside of my credentials and I'm going to create a new credential. I specifically want to create a Windows credential and click on Add Credential. And in here, I'm going to call this my credential. All right, and let's create a login credential into my lab. And the password we're going to use, save and exit. And that's it. And that creates our account to scan Windows computers. Again, that account needs to be a local admin for the Windows machines. If you're scanning a Linux, Mac, SSH, all you need is read-only permissions. Create those in the same way we created the Windows machine scanning credential. Finally, once we have this in place, we need to map that credential to a correct scan target. We're going to do that on the next video. Until then, I'll see you on the next one.